Every division operation results into outputs, quotient and remainder. This how we performs division operation manually. 4537, this is the dividend which is divided by divisor 3. 3 ones are 3, 3 is subtracted from 4 to get remainder 1. 5 from hundreds place is dragged down. 3 5s are 15, it results in 0. 3 ones are 3, on subtracting 3 from 3, we get remainder 0. 7 from 1's place is dragged down. 3 2's are 6. 6 is subtracted from 7 to get final remainder 1. Quotient is 1512. The same division operation is elaborated with this slide. 3 1's are 3 is subtracted from 4. In actual, 3000 is subtracted from 4537 since 4 is situated at location with weightage 10^3 and its value is 4000. Its place value is 4000. 3000 value from 1 multiple of 3 is possible only when this 1 multiple of 3 is present at location with weightage 10^3. As 3 into 1 into 10^3 results in 3000 value, which is subtracted from 4537 to get remainder 1537. Once the position of MSD, that is most significant digit of quotient, is obtained, we get the length of quotient. As MSD or most significant digit is at location with weightage 10^3, certain 3 digit must be there with weightages, certain 3 digits must be there at locations with weightages 10^2, 10^1 and 10^0. Let quotient is represented by Q, then digits from quotient can be specified as Q3, Q2, Q1, Q0. Let this partial remainder 1537 is represented as R3, which is obtained by subtracting 3 into 3 is the divisor, 3 into Q3 into 10^3. Q3 is the multiple of 3. Then R2 can be obtained by subtracting 3 into Q2 into 10^2 from R3. Now the 5 multiple of 3 results in 15. 3 into 5 into 10^2 results in 1500. So on subtracting 1500 from 1537, we get remainder 37. Now from this R2, 3 into Q1 into 10^1 can be subtracted to get R1. Now Q1 is 1, 1 multiple of 3 results in 3 into 1 into 10^1 value, which is 30. So on subtracting 30 from 37, we get remainder 7. Now from this R1, if we subtract 3 into Q0 into 10^0, we get R0. 3 into 2 into 10^0 results in 6 value. So on subtracting 6 from 7, we get remainder 1, which is R0. And R0 represents final remainder. And quotient is represented by Q. So when we combine Q3, Q2, Q1, Q0, we get final quotient value. This iterative subtraction can be represented with this formula. Ri can be obtained by subtracting Qi into D into 10^i from previous remainder Ri plus 1. Where I takes values from n minus 1 to 0. So in this case, dividend is 4 digit long, which is represented by n. I takes values from 3 to 0. So R3 is obtained by subtracting D into Q3 into 10 raised to 3 from R4. So in this case, the original dividend is treated as R4. R2 is obtained by subtracting 3 into Q2 into 10 raised to 2 from R3. R1 is obtained by subtracting 3 into Q1 into 10 raised to 1 from R2. R0 is obtained by subtracting 3 into Q0 into 10 raised to 0 from R1. When we reach to R0, we have to stop this iterative subtraction process as we reach to the final remainder, and we can have the quotient from the quotient register.